Here at Riverside, we offer support for a wide variety of behavioral health issues. Today, we're here with Priscilla Lynch, Clinical Director of Oakside, to discuss some of these issues. Because as a new parent, you might wonder, what are some signs and symptoms? So thank you so much for joining us.
You're very welcome.
Can you tell us what are some common signs and symptoms of common disorders for children and when they might start showing up?
Well, certainly symptoms and different issues arrive at different times for different age groups of children. And one of the most common ones is ADD, attention deficit disorder, or ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, which we typically start seeing symptoms in toddler range age. And those symptoms can include such things as short attention span, the child is more loud and talkative, they oftentimes have difficulty following directions.
The most recent CDC report suggests that 1 in 50 children have autism or are on the spectrum. Can you tell us what are some of those signs and symptoms and when those start to show up?
Yes, certainly we start seeing some behaviors or some symptoms start occurring right around 12 months of age, where a child may have difficulty responding to their name. And the children that tend to be more socially isolated, like to be alone, avoid eye contact, tend to really not do well with minor change. They like routine, predictability. Also, we see sometimes delayed speech and communication patterns. Children with autistic symptomatology tend to obsess over things. They grab onto something and they just go over and over or play with it over and over. And also, some symptoms include a repetitive lining up of different toys, different kinds of things. So those are the typical signs and symptoms that we see on the autism spectrum. And it can certainly include all of those or a variety of those. Also, the one that sometimes people are certainly not aware of is oftentimes children with these problems don't like touch and don't like affection, or they shy away from those kinds of things.
Now, if you're a parent and you start seeing these symptoms, who are some people you can turn to get a diagnosis and learn more information?
Well, I think parents do recognize something may not be quite right. I would recommend starting with your pediatrician. Many pediatricians actually have some training and have knowledge about ADD, ADHD, autism, and if they don't or are not comfortable, they certainly can refer you to neurology people, psychology people.
When this diagnosis becomes real and this parent is in this situation, how can they help their child thrive?
Well, I think there's a variety of ways to do that. Number one, I think it oftentimes starts with parents feeling guilty and then grieving over what's going on. It's overwhelming, it's scary, and oftentimes there's outside resources that are extremely beneficial to help through this process. The issue becomes, I think, what do you do to normalize your life as much as you can, and how do you raise your child in the best way possible so that they thrive and can do well with whatever limitations they might be by living with. And so I'm a believer oftentimes in family therapy, where you bring the whole family in or you do some work with the parents and the child to figure out how do we put things in place that will best work for our family situation.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. At this point, is there anything else that you would like to share?
Yes, I think this diagnosis can be scary. It can be overwhelming to families. And the beauty is that we're learning more and more about these type of disorders. There's certainly a lot of resources out there, and it can allow us to function in a normal family environment, and individuals can lead very normal, highly functioning lives.
I like that. I like the fact that there's hope and there
absolutely.
Is support. And
absolutely.
Right here at Riverside too.
Absolutely, there is.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. Like I said, it's so great to have these services. For more information, be sure to check out Riverside's Behavioral Health Services on our website. Thanks for joining us on this segment of LIV. Join the conversation on social media and visit us at healthcurrents.com. Thank you for joining us on today's segment of LIV.